from where data is to be taken in. All these instructions, when they are executed, they follow different timings. And here I want to introduce a typical fundamental of a digital systems. You know that digital system follows a digital clock, and usually we have digital clock of this particular type. Right? You also know that if I call it as a clock, then system would work within this duration, on time. During off time, it won't do anything. Some task will be done here, 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 etc., etc. I will call this as T1, I will call this as T2, this as T3, this as T4, T5, so on, so forth. Microprocessor is a digital device. It has a clock connected to it. Remember the pin X1, XY to which we had connected a crystal, and crystal of a specific frequency, and that frequency generates a timing diagram of this type. Depending upon what frequency crystal you have connected, you will have this time period. If you have connected 5 megahertz crystal, then 1 upon 5 microsecond will be the duration of this T1. Right? Sorry, divide by 2 further, 1 by 10, 0.1 microsecond. So, this particular timing will be fixed by the crystal that you are connecting. T1 will be same as T2, T3, because it is a digital clock you are connecting. During T1, some actions will be performed. During T2, some actions will be performed. T3, T4, some actions will be performed. For 8085, T1, T2, T3 and T4 constitute one particular cycle called M1. M1 is a machine cycle. This machine cycle M1 consists of T1, T2, T3, T4, 4 clocks. So within 4 clocks, M1 machine cycle exists. If you have implicit addressing instruction, then it is a single byte instruction, and single byte instruction will get executed in this M1 itself. If it is 2-byte instruction, immediate category, then M1 is not enough. After M1, you would require one more cycle called M2. But M2 is not 4T but 3T cycle. Remember, M1 is 4T cycle, M2 is 3T cycle. So, if it is single byte instruction, M1 is enough. If it is immediate, then M1 plus M2, 4T plus 3T, this much time will be required. And if it is register addressing, then you would need one more machine cycle, M1, M2 and M3. M1 4T cycles, M2 3T cycles, M3 again 3T cycles. So total 4 plus 3 plus 3, 10T states, 10T periods will be required. and depending upon the crystal you are connecting, you can know this periodic time, and you can use this periodic time to calculate as to how much time each instruction will take to get executed by microprocessor. Higher the frequency, lower is the periodic time, and higher is the speed of execution of the instruction. But for 8085, upper limit is 5 megahertz. For 8085, upper limit is 10 megahertz. So you can't connect higher frequency crystal than 10 megahertz to 8085A. For higher speed, you need to go to some different microprocessor. So you have these M1, M2, M3. And call instruction, which is a hybrid instruction, which is a combined instruction, needs more machine cycles, because there is one instruction call, which is immediate address 3-byte one. It is a 3-byte instruction. So you require M1, M2, M3. But after completing this, it has to do one more task, and that is push the content of program counter onto stack. Stack is a memory location whose address is available in stack pointer. So you require three more machine cycles. So first M1, M2, M3, it will push the content, and next M1, M2, M3, it will get the address loaded in program counter and then execute. So you require more than 6 machine cycles in such instructions. If it is a plain implicit address, you require only 1 machine cycle. If it is an immediate, you require 2 or 3 machine cycles, depending upon whether you are loading data or register. A pair address. If it is different kind of third category instruction, then you require minimum 3. But for hybrid mixed mechanism, you require more than 6 machine cycles at a time. All these timing diagrams, they are called as the timing diagrams of instructions. We'll come back to these timing diagrams after one more session of programming is over. After writing some examples, we'll come back, because this machine cycle thing, timing diagram part, belongs to the hardware side of microprocessor. So we'll come back to it later, after having gone through programming, assembly language programming, and after solving some examples of assembly language programming. Some time we'll spend on to understanding T cycles, and we will try to calculate how much time microprocessor will take to execute the program what we wrote. You can refer to this particular timing diagrams, timing cycles, in your textbook and reference books meanwhile, and try to understand some more part. Right now, remember that you require more than 1 machine cycle depending upon category of these instructions. Let me quickly go through one more mechanism to categorize instructions. As I told you, we have plenty instructions in microprocessor 8085, and we can't remember them all unless and until we categorize. One method of categorizing we did. Now we'll go for another categorization of that particular instruction set. These are functional. So far, we took care of addressing mechanism. So far, we put ourselves at a microprocessor mind and try to think, how would I get the data onto which this operation is performed? We asked a question, how to get a data, where is the data, on which operation is to be performed, and based on that we defined different methods of addressing. Now, another mechanism to categorize this instruction set will follow logical one, and in that logical one we have data transfer group, arithmetic group, logical group, branch group, stack IO, and machine control instruction type. We have these many categories, and let us quickly go through one by one. These are the examples for data transfer group. Name tells you what is happening. Data is being transferred. Transferred from register to register, isn't it? Or from register to memory. Or we are loading the data into some register pair or single register. Move, it stands for movement. Example I gave you is move M, sorry, B comma C. When I write move B comma C, it would mean content of register C move to register B. I have given another example, move immediate. Move immediate C comma 9, hexadecimal. So hexadecimal number 9 as a data is moved to register C. Load accumulator, LDA, load accumulator with some particular data here. What is the data? In the next byte, immediate address. Data is there, that data is moved to accumulator. Please note, move and load perform the same operation. Instead of LDA data, I could have written MVIA comma 9H. It would have performed the same thing. Instead of writing that LDA 09, I would have written MVIA comma 9. It would have performed the same thing. But load is a typical thing we use in computer jargon. You ask yourself, have you loaded the program in a computer? Have you loaded the CD? Have you loaded PowerPoint presentation? You use that term load, and that load term originates from here. For specific data, we use term load, and that's why these instructions load are also given in microprocessor. You have LHLD. LHLD. Now you have to read this LHLD in a specific form. L and D you read together, and HL you read separately. So this stands for load HL pair. LDHL. You don't write LDHL. You write LHLD. Load HL pair with some particular address given here as a lower byte and here as a higher byte. This is same as LXI. This is same as LXIH. So when you write LXIH LB comma HB, it would execute the same way as LHLD is being executed. As I already told you, X stands for register pair, I stand for immediate, LD stands for load. So LDAX, when I write, it would mean load accumulator. It would STAX would mean store accumulator. XCHG. This is a single byte instruction, and this single byte instruction would mean exchange. Exchange of what? program counter content with HL pair. Content of HL pair moves to program counter, and content of program counter moves to HL pair. So exchange between HL and PC happens when you give exchange kind of instruction. So previous slide gave you example of 8-bit data movement. The second slide, the present one, is giving you some examples of 16-bit data transfer. So that is the movement type. The another category is arithmetic category. And in arithmetic category, you have add, A double D, and it is add register B comma C, for example. So content of register C added to B. You can have add M comma L. It would mean add the content of register L to the content at memory location M whose address is provided by HL pair. Similarly, you have ADI, add immediate, data. So content at accumulator A are added with data immediately available. Immediate instruction, immediate addressing. So this data is added to accumulator. You have one more, ADC, B comma C, or let me write B comma D. Under this instruction, what will happen? Content of register D are added to register B with previous carry available. Add with carry, ADC stands for add with carry. So carry flag will also be added. In ADD B comma D, only contents of B and D will be available, added, and carry flag C content will not be added. But in this ADC B comma D, contents of B and D are added together with carry flag C. Likewise, you have SUB for subtract, SBB for subtract with borrow. You have SBI, subtract immediate, etc. You have INR for increment register. You have decrement DCR. You have INX, increment register pair. Whenever X comes in, please note it is a register pair we are talking of. Decrement register pair, DCX. And DAD, D-A-D, DAD is a specific instruction which is a double addition. We'll take the example of this DAD. DAD is a double addition. It doesn't mean that two bytes are added two times. No. This DAD instruction is for 16-bit addition. You have content in register pair HL. You have content in register pair BC. So register HL and BC contents are added. Now you are adding 16-bit data. That is a specific provision that has been provided in 8085 for 16-bit data handling as well. Logical group. For this logical group, you have AND, AME, accumulator. Contents are ANDed with some register, so ANA B, for example, ANA comma B. This is the instruction. When I write ANA comma B, it would mean AND register content B with accumulator content A. And this AND is a logical AND. You know, digitally you have AND operation, you have OR operation, you have XOR operation, you have XNOR operation, You have NAND operation, you have NOR operation, but only few are possible. Here AND operation is possible, OR operation is possible, and XOR operation is possible, and here are the examples cited. So you have this as logical group. Some more logical group instructions are: rotate left, contents of accumulator are rotated left. This is something needs some small explanation. Let us say your accumulator contains this particular data, 8-bit data, and this is accumulator content at a given moment, and now I am writing RL, rotate left. Rotate accumulator left. What will happen in this situation? This one will get shifted to the left hand side, this one will get shifted to left hand side, this zero will get shifted to left hand side, this one will get shifted to, and one more shift operations of this type will happen, and this zero will go to carry flag, and carry flag contents will come here. This is how operation will be performed. Why rotate left and rotate right instructions are provided to us by manufacturer? Please note, in binary algebra you must have seen that rotate left and rotate right are respectively multiply and divide. If you want to multiply by 2 some particular binary number, simply rotate left. If you want to divide it by 2, then simply rotate right. So rotate operations are often required for multiply as well as divide. Of course, multiply you can write a program by sequential addition. Divide you can write a program by sequential subtraction, but here is one shortcut available. If it is division by 2 or division multiplication by 2, then instead of using loops for addition, you can use rotate left and rotate right kind of operations as well. You have one more instruction, complement. Complement is just change. If your accumulator content is 0 1 1 0 1 0 1 1, complement would mean 0 0 1 0 1 0 0 1. Just replace 1 by 0 and 0 by 1. That is a complement. One's complement. So one's complement can be achieved using complement accumulator. You can perform these two operations, rotate left right and complement, through carry as well. And through carry you have instruction RAL, rotate accumulator left, RLC through rotate left through carry, and rotate right through carry RRC. So RLC and RRC are also available, and you have CMC, complement carry flag. You have set carry flag. So these are the instructions which come under logical instruction. Branch instruction. Please remember, we have used already some example of call. In call instructions, what we did? We branched out from a given program to another program, subroutine. And after finishing that subroutine, we came back to the main program where we left, and we continued. This is a branching. Branching means a normal flow of the program is broken, and it is broken for some specific task going to some subroutine, and from that subroutine coming back to the previous part over here. So here you are branching.